2.3 seconds to go. UMass down 80-77. Anton slaps the ball, looks for Barbie, turn around, goal!
It never pays to celebrate too early. It was the Minutemen who caught the bus to Madison Square Garden and UMass basketball's finest season ever. O'clock midnight on October 15th, the Minutemen played host to a capacity crowd at the cage to officially open the 1990-91 season. The Minutemen's charismatic leader, head coach John Calipari, has taken the UMass program to new heights. Now vying for a spot in the top 20, UMass is playing a schedule filled with national powers. Coach Calipari wanted to test his still young Minutemen early in the season, opening the year with Purdue at West Lafayette in Indiana. Certainly a tough test, but UMass held their own against the Big Ten powered Boilermakers. Tony Barbie returned to play in his home state of Indiana, but it was Will Herndon's 21 points and 5 rebounds that kept the game close. Get up and make it happen. Get on your feet. Stand up and take some action. Get on your feet. The weight is on your shoulders. The Minutemen return home to open the season after consecutive road wins at St. Joe's and New Hampshire. The unveiling of last year's NIT banner preceded a grudge match against Lowell in the opener. The result, a thorough 80-57 payback for last season's upset. Junior guard Jim McCoy led 5 Minutemen in double figures with 17 as UMass rolled over Division II Lowell. Later, George Washington got hit by a Herndon-Barbie tidal wave in an exciting 82-70 sellout at the cage. Herndon led all scorers with 26 points and ripped down 9 rebounds. Sophomore Tony Barbie added 25 points of his own, while Jim McCoy chipped in a very quiet 18. Rutgers completed the 3-game homestand with what was one of many last-second finishes. The capacity crowd has the cage rocking once again as the Minutemen battled the Scarlet Knights down to the wire. A last-second shot gave the visitors the victory, and UMass its first loss of the Atlantic 10 season.
Anton Brown hurt his knee today and is going to be out 8 weeks, which basically means he'll be out the season. And it sets us back, but, our team is a strong team, and we've dealt with a lot of adversity, so we'll just see what happens.
And what happened was the Minutemen did indeed rally around their injured teammate en route to the championship in the first annual Abdow's Hall of Fame tournament. The win over Dartmouth came in the opening round, followed by the championship game victory over Big East member Boston College, thanks to Rayford Giles' last-second heroics. Harper Williams claimed MVP honors, while Jim McCoy and Tony Barbie were all tournament selections. Then returned to the friendly confines of the cage after a rugged loss at Penn State to play St. Bonaventure. Every Minuteman scored in the 82-55 rout of the Bonnies. Junior Anton Brown returned earlier than expected from a potentially season-ending injury to spark the Minutemen over St. Joe's for the second time in the year. Will Herndon led the way with a spectacular 22 points and some of his trademark high-flying slams. Sophomore forward Harper Williams recorded his third double-double with 10 points and 16 rebounds. Five-game road swing, the lowest of the year, took the Minutemen to St. Bonaventure, NCAA tournament-bound Xavier, Vermont, Temple, and George Washington. UMass split the first two with a win at St. Bonaventure and a hard-fought loss to Xavier, where they hold a 92-10 record in their home gym. The Minutemen continued their domination of New England teams with a physical win over Vermont, 62-58. The trek continued to arch-rival Temple, where UMass suffered a heartbreaking loss in the final seconds of the game. Then it was on to Washington for more of the same, the second straight two-point defeat at the hands of the George Washington Colonials. Finally arriving back in Amherst for four straight home games, the Minutemen were happy to see the cage once again. Holy Cross, the first victim, fell in a high-scoring rough-and-tumble shootout at the cage, 98-94. William Herndon led the way for all five starters in double figures with 23. Rafer Giles sank a three-pointer for his 1,000th point while leading the Minutemen past Rhode Island in overtime. Midnight Madness arrived for the second time this season on ESPN, the first ever nationally televised game from the cage.
This was the scene less than 3 hours ago outside of the Curry Hicks cage on the campus of the University of Massachusetts, where tonight the Minutemen will host the BU Terriers. 3,000 students vying for 2,000 tickets. They didn't have to worry about this before John Calipari took over the program because they only averaged 1,800 fans. Tonight, it's a packed house, over 4,000 watching the Minutemen against the BU Terriers. There's Coach John Calipari in his third year here at University of Massachusetts Minutemen, and we have a presentation tonight.
And please hold your applause until after this announcement. Thank you. Last night, a UMass basketball player became the 18th UMass player to score 1,000 career points. He sank the basket that beat the University of Rhode Island. Head coach John Calipari will now present last night's game ball to the latest member of the 1,000-point club. Please recognize Rafer Giles.
pick up their 14th victory of the season. If you ever get a chance to watch a basketball game, please come to UMass.
Possibly the most exciting game of the year, full of close ones, West Virginia took the Minutemen to overtime before finally prevailing 85-82. Harper Williams had 23 points and a career-high 17 rebounds in the losing effort. After splitting a pair of road games, a first-ever win in Morgantown against the Mountaineers, and another one-point loss to Duquesne, the Minutemen return home to play Penn State, always a tough foe.
It was senior night at Duquesne. Matt Anderson, Ben Grotzky, John Tate, and Rafer Giles honored before the game. And what a game in the first half. Neither Penn State nor UMass could build a sizable lead. Back and forth they went. Will Herndon down one end. The Lions' Dave Deggetts down the other. Harper Williams puts UMass up by two before becoming the human floor mop. But Deggetts ties it back up for Penn State. Finally, UMass got a little bit of an edge. Jim McCoy hits, and the Minutemen led by five at the half, 37-32. Second half, McCoy continued to be on fire. He hit 11 of his first 12 shots, and after the game, credited his father for his improved shooting. Watch Will Herndon take the pass from Rafer Giles and nail the reverse, and Penn State head coach Bruce Parkhill not pleased. UMass clicked in the second half, building up a big lead. McCoy gets the hoop and foul. Jimmy finished with 25 points tonight. Tony Barbee let the crowd know he's back from his bout with mono with the Barbee slam. But the Lions wouldn't sleep, cutting the lead to three with 28 seconds left. But another Barbee slam would seal it. The Minutemen and King Calipari beat Penn State 73-64.
The word going into the Temple game was the streak stops here. Unfortunately, the frustrations continued against the Owls. The Minutemen suffered a poor shooting night, never really hitting stride. McCoy and Barbee knocked down 18 points apiece in the loss. UMass finished the season with road games at Rutgers and Rhode Island. The Scarlet Knights tripped up the Minutemen once again despite Jim McCoy's 30 points. UMass rebounded to beat Rhode Island 82-70 to end up in a tie for third place in the Atlantic 10. Atlantic 10 tournament was a rugged battle between the Minutemen and the Colonials of George Washington. Just like the first two games, both teams played well, but in this contest, foul trouble was the deciding factor. With Harper Williams, John Tate, and Will Herndon all watching the final minutes of the game from the sidelines, the Colonials were able to pull out a win, ending the dream of an NCAA tournament appearance in 1991. The NCAA tournament is still a goal to be reached. UMass has back-to-back appearances in the NIT with a 20-win season to be proud of. And the NIT gave UMass its first ever tournament game in the cage against the LaSalle Explorers. All-time leading scorer Jim McCoy led the Minutemen against high-scoring Doug Overton of the Explorers. When the dust finally settled, UMass prevailed in the red-hot cage, 93-90. The Fordham Rams were unbeaten in their gym this season until last night. The UMass Minutemen, backed by an enthusiastic group of fans, take over the Bronx. William Herndon got it going, and the fight was on. The Rams were up early, but UMass led by two at the half. Harper Williams shows the way. In the second half, once again, Fordham led briefly, but the Minutemen respond. Sharpshooter Jim McCoy was cold, and so the other guys step up. Anton Brown scores. Tony Barbee hit consecutive three-point bombs to give UMass a six-point lead. Then McCoy caught fire. Suddenly, UMass led by 12. When William Herndon jams one home off the Anton Brown steal, it was a 14-point lead, and it looked like a rout. But Fordham comes all the way back, almost all the way. They pulled within two. It was gut check time for John Calipari's Minutemen, but they perform at the line. Harper Williams led everyone with 23, and UMass wins it. UMass takes it 78-74. It's the first time they've ever won two consecutive postseason games.
You go from one oven to another now. You got to go to Siena and play.
Hey, we're still playing. You know there's 24 teams playing, and UMass is one of them. Play. Tell us where to play. Anchorage, Puerto Rico, we'll play.
With the Minutemen, I'm Rich Tetimer, News Center 22.
It's called the UMass Shuffle, and it's the talk of the town after the Minutemen shocked the Siena Saints and super guard Mark Brown. Thousands of Siena fans were prematurely shouting with glee, but engraved in their minds forever will be a man named Barbee. For 2 hours, the teams put on quite a show, the craziest thing since Larry, Curly, and Moe.
It was a fun game for the kids. I mean, it was a battle, it was a war.
With 5 seconds left, the shots had to be right. UMass down by two with Harper Williams at the stripe. The first shot was good, the Minutemen down by one, but the second was not. And it looked like UMass was done.
I wasn't scared of nothing. I was just like, I just shot the shot and it just rolled out. I was like, it wasn't meant to be. I don't know.
Then the shot of the century, Tony Barbee gave it all he had. And after it went in, he graciously thanked his dad. Amherst will never be the same after Tony's buzzer beater. But don't forget the heroics of Jimmy McCoy, the team's leader. For it was he who in overtime scored the only basket, and UMass was victorious. Siena gets the casket.
Tony, baby, you're going to Madison Square
Garden. Yes, we know it. You know it.
Ready for baby, you're going to Madison Square Garden.
That's great. I can't wait. Damn!
And what was thought to be a tale told by a fairy turned into a dream come true for King Calipari. The Minutemen keep dancing, for they have another date. March 25th at the Garden. Don't be late.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime chance for a lot of us, you know. Most of us, you know, our career is going to be over after this game. You know, and I think, you know, we're just going to have to play the game and, you know, live it as it comes, you know. It's a once-in-a-lifetime chance.
Tonight, tonight, four players from the final quartet continue their quest of a childhood dream to play in the NIT Finals at New York's legendary Madison Square Garden.
Playing in the Garden made the whole season a success, but the Minutemen weren't satisfied just to be there. They came to win. Many people thought that the two hottest teams in the tournament were UMass and Stanford, and so the championship game was being played in the first round. It was a war. Stanford came out on fire, ahead by as many as 16 points in the first half. Slowly, the Minutemen climbed back into it. Big plays by Giles and Herndon and steady play by Harper Williams kept it close. But in the end, the Cardinals were just too strong inside. The Minutemen's first trip to the NIT Final Four ended in a loss, but it was a journey we will always remember. It was a year of firsts. The first 20-win season for young John Calipari. The first nationally televised game from the cage. The first time a UMass team hosted an NIT game. And the first time UMass has gone to the NIT Final Four. Yes, it was a year of firsts, but it's sure not to be the last. 31.